Alright guys, and welcome to a snapshot video of 12W07B. I haven't really done one of these before, so I don't know how it's gonna go. But I just wanted to show you guys a few new features that will be introduced in the next update that we've already seen. So I guess we will begin, since I found this village, with the testificate actually repopulating. So if I kill a testificate, then I'll kill a few just to make sure. Other testificates will attempt to refill the houses that have been left vacant by reproducing. It's a little bit dodgy. But let's just fly around so we can see some. Guys, making love. I might have particles set off, actually. Okay. So hopefully we should see some love making. Come on. Where are you, little baby testificates? Where are you? Where you at? Oh, there's one. There it is. Yeah. So you get these little guys. And they just look really creepy and like little baby doll heads. Another thing that's been introduced is that at night, I can't really show you it right now, but at night the all the testificates will run inside and hide, and if there's enough zombies around, then they will attempt to break down the door, which I will show you at night time. But for now, I'm going to show you the increased block height. So we're on a super flat wall, so we're right next to bedrock anyway. But the block height has gone up to 256, which is a hell of a lot taller than it's ever been before. Normally you could only reach that from mods. But this is going to add like loads of new opportunities in building. I know in some of my creative maps, which I don't really show you guys because it's more to pass the time, but I try to build extremely tall things, and super flats helped, but hopefully on these new ones we will be able to reach ever increasing heights. So that is a awesome feature that's been added, and I'm just attempting to show you exactly how tall you can get. I'm pretty sure it's out of view of the town. I was just trying to see where the sun is, but it goes on for a long time. It doesn't take that long to fall though, just saying. I wish it took long to fall. Okay, I think I've reached it. Yep, I've reached it. Okay, so just to give you an idea, it took me ages to get up here, and this is how tall it is. Yeah. Ooh, and just something I noticed while I was on a creative map yesterday. If I come back up to the top of this, just because we're trying to kill time because of the sun, I've noticed that the ocelots don't actually take any fall damage whatsoever. I think it's like intended because they're cats, and they say cats always land on their feet and stuff. But I just thought it was really cool, and I haven't seen anybody show it yet, so it wasn't exactly put in this update, I don't think. But I want to show you just how it can survive that fall. So I guess I'll put a wolf there as well, just to show you the difference. So wolf, that will die. You won't see it at the bottom, but you'll see the ocelot. So no wolf down there. Ocelot seems fine. Just runs off. Okay. So I guess I'll make a jump cut until nighttime. Alright guys, it's nighttime now, and I bet you're wondering what all this is. Well, in this update they introduced a new light source that is powered by redstone. So yep, just what I've done is I've made a load of glowstone, glowstone, redstone torches underneath there, and then lit them all up. And as you can see, everybody wants to get inside now because it's night time. If I go outside, you'll see I might have to spawn a few in. The zombies will attack. Wait, there we go. The zombies will attempt to attack any testificates nearby. So I'm just gonna go all out on this. They'll just break down these. Break down the doors. What? Difficulty me up. Okay. Just break down the doors and take out whoever's inside. So if I hit a few and drag them over to me. Oh, and all animals are using the new AI systems so that they can find you. So if I just go in here, let me in. Okay. And just wait for them to break down the door. Then that would be about it. The new light sources are called, I think it's redstone lamps. Yeah, redstone lamps. Oh god, it got in. Ah, see, they break down the door. Sorry, I couldn't show you that. But yeah, redstone lamps, Zombageddon, repopulation testificates, and I think new blockites. So that's it for the new update. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give it a like if you liked it, favorite the video if you extremely liked it, and then you can comment on any feedback you would like to give. Our Facebook page is in the description. Take a look at that. And I will see you guys next time. Ooh, guys, one thing I forgot to mention is when you kill mobs, you get random drops that, you like, items that you wouldn't normally get from them. So you'd expect to get rotten meat, and you might get, like, an iron sword. In one of the updates, this was like extremely high chance. They've taken that down, so if I just kill all of these guys, I'll show you what I mean. So I don't know if I'll get drop at all. And maybe I should have made it a bit higher. I will attempt this again. There we go. Just put that there. And put load in there. If I can. God, this is trickier than I expected. So, damn it. Not let me in. I'll just put them down like that. Surrounded by zombies. It's never a good thing. Okay. If I just show you guys. And you will get items like iron swords and stuff like that. I guess it's for survival, just to help you in the game. If you don't have like all the items that you could craft. I don't know. You might get a bucket. Or a bed. That'd be nice. Just kill this last one. And there we go. One iron sword. So that's it. And I will see you guys next time.